checklist. A checklist of the things that you're going to need when doing your concrete stain project. You're going to need tape and plastic. Again, I like to recommend the kind that has the tape already adhered to the plastic. That's the easiest and the quickest. But you do need to cover the walls, the doors, etc. with some kind of tape and plastic. If you're working outdoors, you could use a piece of cardboard or a painter's shield rather than tape and plastic, but you'll have to decide on that. Supplies that you need to protect yourself would be long pants, long sleeve shirt, closed shoes or boots, masks such as dust masks, goggles, gloves. They can be disposable gloves or non-disposable gloves, but they need to be chemical resistant and water resistant. And if you're using a solvent-based sealer, then you would use respiratory protection as needed. If you do decide to use respiratory protection, then we recommend the NIOSH/MSHATC23C or equivalent. The other thing that you need as far as protecting yourself is common sense and a safe and unhurried attitude. If you're going to be scoring the concrete, you need a tape measure, a pencil, a chalk line with blue chalk, never use red chalk, always use blue, an extension cord, either a skill saw with a diamond blade or a 4.5-inch angle grinder with a diamond blade. You need a straight edge, and that's what you keep the saw up against, or you'll use a thin straight edge to run the grinder down. That's what keeps your lines perfectly straight, and you're going to need a square, like a 2-foot square. Supplies and tools that you need to clean is a water hose if you're working outside or a power washer. You're going to need TSP, which is trisodium phosphate, and you'll either need a mop bucket or a 5-gallon bucket. You're going to need any kind of citrus cleaners or strippers or heavy-duty glue removers or mastic removers if you have any glues or paint or anything of that nature that needs to be stripped off. You're going to need a degreaser, a good concrete degreaser, if you have any oil or grease on the concrete that needs to be degreased.
If you're working with concrete and you don't know its history, make sure you use Concrete Camouflage's Concrete Stain Prep Degreaser for the best results.
It would be a good idea to have some rags handy, and you're going to need a soft bristle push broom. You'll need a mop, a bucket, and maybe even a wet dry vac if you want to use a wet dry vac. You may need scrub brushes. You may need scrapers. You may need knee pads. You may need a sander if you have glue and stickies on the surface that causes you to need to lightly sand it, or you could use a floor buffing machine with a sanding disc. And if you have any patches that need to be taken care of, then you're going to need a good concrete patch material. And if you do use a concrete patch material, you're going to need a concrete trowel and a concrete rubbing stone if you're going to patch it. Supplies and tools that you need to apply the stain. You'll need a small 1-gallon all-plastic pump-up sprayer, like a weed sprayer. And if you want to use a brush, then you're going to need a soft bristle brush with a handle. By soft bristle, I mean soft bristle like the one that you would find at the car wash.
Don't be that guy.
You may want a paintbrush, a small paintbrush, if you're doing anything artistic or if you're doing borders or anything along those lines. And in that event, you would need a small bucket. You could use an empty ice cream bucket. Again, you're going to need things for a good entry-exit point. That would be some rags or some old towels. That way it keeps you from tracking dirt in or stain out. You're going to need brooms, mops, buckets for cleaning the residue or the water hose. And you're going to need ammonia to neutralize the stain. Supplies and tools needed to apply the sealer. You're going to need a roller cage with the handle and the covers, adequate ventilation, of course, and you're going to need an electric drill with the paint stirring rod in the event that you're going to use a sealer with a traction additive. You're going to need a paint pan, and in the event that you decide that you're going to spray on the sealer, then you'll need a sprayer. But even if you spray it, you're going to need to back roll it with the paint roller. The tools that you're going to need to apply the wax, you're going to need a clean paint pan, and you're going to need either a lamb's wool applicator or a synthetic wax applicator. And that's pretty much the list of everything you might possibly need.